How's that for good timing? Hello everybody and welcome back to Ark Survival Evolved. My name is Wolfart and today we are back on Scorched Earth because we're finally going to be building our base. I am doing one round of collecting sand because I believe this is all the sand I'm going to need to finish construction. Okay, that's... holy cow. I didn't realize I got that much sand. Okay, dude. Just follow me then. Alright, today we're going to be finishing up construction. You can see I did the wall, which the wall is going to change because I decided to use something that I wasn't planning on using at first. And you'll notice that looks different too. That is because I am now using S+, the Structures Plus mod. And dude can't figure out how to get through the wall. wonderful. So, for Structures Plus, I got this fun crafting station right here. That is not what I'm in here for. That is. Let's get those going. Let's get rid of that. And this. I've been cooking up a lot of metal. I think when I first dumped all my metal in there, it said 920. So I've been cooking up a decent amount of metal. Dude, you can stop now. Get you out of the water. Hello. Oh, you're actually going to take something of value. Go away. Let's get back inside and close him out. Goodbye. Alright, so today we're going to be finishing up our build here. But as I said, we are now using S+. I should have enough walls and ceilings. Once this is done, you'll notice that's gone as well. Everything is in here. I need some of this stuff. I need some food. I really need some food. I just finished off all my food. The hell? Why do I have 76 spoiled meat in there? Wrong one. I'll show you that in a second. Take those out. There we go. That'll work on there. Toss you guys in there for now. Alright, so I've been working hard, doing a lot of things. As you can see, I've been working on getting some tranquilizer darts in here. I've also been working on construction stuff. We have in here a bunch of guns that are all related to S+. Fun stuff. We've got the S+, forges, mortar, pestle, smithy, then just a bunch of construction materials. We're going to build a couple of things on it today. Like I said, I think I have enough walls to be able to finish this place. I think. There's one spot in particular that I do want to make sure we get done. So we'll take these. They're the only ones that are specific to that spot. And that is this back corner. So you'll also notice that I was able to extend it back. That is because of S+. S+ removes the requirement of clipping. And the walls that I'm building on my... my playthrough on the center is with the S+ stuff as well, so I'm going to actually end up replacing these ones with that too. That's because, like, over there, I cannot build that any higher. It will not let me. Actually, I could probably do it with one of these walls. Yeah, I can do it with an S+ wall, not a regular wall. And also, this is a bit ridiculous. I can just walk right out of my... lock right under my wall. Dude, stop following me. You are about to walk right off again. You, sir, need to stop. Slide right back up here. He is oh so slow. Then again, we kind of weighed him down a bit by ourselves. Alright, so we have one little corner back here, which is going to be very specific. This is going to be for power. We're going to put a generator back here. But in order to do that, I want to get the actual structure around it built. And this wall will go that way. I like the arrow that actually points which direction the wall faces. No more confusion. Okay, so we got those. Got these guys that I gotta figure out which one is which. Okay, that answers my questions. That is one of my other favorite things that I've seen about S pluses. You can have these upside down. Oh my gosh, does that open up so many options? Not that I'm using any of them right now, but it opens up so many options. Let's go ahead and we will put these guys up here. Now that is going to be the only sloped roof we use on this structure. Because this structure is not about slopes. It's going to be very boxy. It's going to be very, how would you say it? That was the wrong one. There we go. It's going to be very, I want to call it, I have nowhere near enough walls. I was hoping I had enough walls here. You do not go there. Haha! Another thing that I love about S+. Wall doesn't go there? Just pick it up. gotta love that. Okay. It's very, I guess you can say, like the, it's going to fit the Adobe style. So, how, I can't really say that. How it normally is very boxy structures just kind of push up against each other. That's the kind of style I like with this. That's the kind of style I envisioned with this Adobe stuff, and that was what I originally had planned. Let's just make as many of those as we can. Let's grab some of these. I have a window. Oh, I also have a door that I need to put in. So yeah, this room back here is going to be for our power. It's going to have a generator. It's going to have a little chest with some gasoline. That's all this room is going to have. That's its sole purpose. Also, automatic doors. Gotta love them. So this part is going to have a flat roof. Oh, gotta love how that stuff works. And I'm actually getting started on another build here as well. We're not going to actually start it today. And I'm out of roofs again. I just keep running out of stuff. I have one wall or one window I can put up. We're going to go ahead. We're going to put you right there. Perfect spot. But I started the placement for a build. And it's going to be built out of Adobe is Adobe again. See, that looks good. To me, that just looks good. I'm also going to put a little railing around the top there. But we're going to have a build right here that, starting with that one, I might redo it. I don't like how it the angle it came out at. don't know. I might leave it like that. But what I'm going to do right here is we're going to have a floating greenhouse that's going to be on stilts over the water. Just because I think it'll look cool. And it'll have a little walkway that comes over here. I tried to lower it so it's decently with the ground. Otherwise, it would have run flush with like this level. Although, I could have done that too. I haven't quite decided on how I'm going to do that one yet. It's very much a work in progress. Dude, where are you? Come here. I need you over here so you can keep building stuff. So, I wanted to get this stuff really, like, started, built, put together, so I can actually venture out from the base and not get stuck here. Like I have been. Being able to actually go out and do something would be a good thing. I have not ventured outside of these walls, with the exception of resource gathering, in forever. I did look around at some of the dinos around here. I'm still trying to collect some from my center world. I was like, what the heck is that on the wall? That's a Carno. But this guy caught my attention. He's stuck there. He's stuck on the rocks. And he's level 108. We are going to need a Parasaur at some point so we can tame a rock elemental. And he might be a good candidate. I think we have a couple extra walls. That's perfectly fine because they will get used for the greenhouse build. It's not going to be like my normal greenhouses that are just all the greenhouse glass stuff. Now, these are going to have some of the other stuff as well. Ooh, I have no wood. Here, let me steal a bunch of that, because I know you're not going to need it. And how much clay do we have in here? 200. It's not going to be enough. I need what, 5? I got 3. Alright. But I really wanted to get the main structure built so that we can finally say, hey, let's get rid of this place. And I finally made one of these freaking things. I've been sitting there, like, moving food around between their inventories, and I finally decided, you know what, I had enough, so I made a feeding trough. Now, we need that there. We'll put this guy up here. We are going to have a roof access, because I do want to put the birds up there when I have them. But we're going to put it back here. Where are you trying to place? Where am I picking up all this stone and sand? I have... Okay, there it is. There's where I want it. There we go. Now, let's see if it has the same bug I had on my other world. But that was with the vanilla ones. No, it doesn't have it! So, when I was playing on the other world, the problem I was having was when you get to this upper lip, I would get stuck in the ceiling. So, I'd actually have to use the ghost command and float up. And then turn off ghosting so I could land on the ceiling every single time I wanted to go up that ladder. It was so annoying. I couldn't stand it anymore. I was actually about to the point that I was going to say that I wasn't going to do anything on these roofs. I was not going to make these roofs usable unless I could get a ladder that would work. Didn't I make more than one? I did. I still have them in my inventory. What in the heck am I doing? I'm like, what the heck? What happened to them? They're still sitting in my inventory. And finished. Kinda. We are going to do a little bit of decorating. We are going to do a little bit of spicing up the outside as well. I'm going to go ahead and close all the windows for now. Just so we get a good idea of how this thing's going to look when we come up to it from anywhere. Look at that thing. I think it looks good. And it's going to have a little rim around the edge on the top with the railing. Or I might do the fence foundations. I haven't decided. Either one would work. It would give it a little bit of a lip. I think the railing would look better. I think we can make a couple of them. There we go. Here, let's make a few of each. If we don't like them, we can get rid of them. And then what we'll do is we will decide which one we want, and we'll go with that for the rest of it. I don't even know how many I'd need. That was what, 16 ceilings? That gives me... six, 12... No. 6, 14, 20? About 20 of these things to do this? Oh, I was going to go on the roof to do it. That's why I wanted this access back here, was because one, I'm going to put the birds up there, and two, I need access. If I'm actually going to put this stuff up here. So let's see how these ones look. On this side... interesting. Interesting. I'll put these guys on this side. They don't snap. Well, yeah, I guess this is going to be railings. Perfect. How does that actually look? I like that look. But I don't like the one that's sticking up. Here, we can get rid of these. Actually, get some of my stuff back from them. I can hide those? That would be nice. I should set that door to not be automatic. See if we can get this to set right. Perfect! How can I do this? Switch to manual. Oh, there we go. Switch to automatic. Auto close only. So that means it'll close on its own, but I still have to open it. I like that. Hey, there we go. So we got the beginnings of our new base. Not really the beginnings. We've got the main structure. It's just doing little details now to make it nice. Let's go ahead and get our stuff from over here. We're going to move things to the inside while I get some more of these cooking. I can only make three. What am I out of? Clay? Am I out of thatch? No, I'm out of wood. Of all the things I could run out of, do I have wood in here? I do not. I just have the wood in here. Yeah, I don't even need that much in there. Look at me bouncing all over the place with inventory. That's the one thing I do like about having these small bases, is that inventory is all clustered together. Oh, I was gonna grab this stuff. Alright, so now we can start placing our actual... Well, we can place some stuff. I can't place the... There... S plus for that. I want to put the mortar and pestles on a table. And I like doing the S plus stuff because it's easy enough to rearrange if I want to. You can see there's all kinds of insane stuff in here. There's all the new tech stuff, which I will have to find some way to unlock that. Okay. No, there is no S plus stuff for that. So I have the S plus smithy and these S plus refining forges. And another bonus to these is that they can actually call resources from everywhere else, as long as they're close enough. So we're going to go ahead and put the smithy over here in the corner. And I can actually push it up against the wall. It's actually against the wall. Oh wow, I got that really close. And I'll put these guys... right there. Yeah. That looks good. Looks like it kind of drifts towards the wall a little bit, but you know what? I can't be perfect. So now I gotta figure out where I want to put the bed, where I want to put a little bit of storage, where I want to put the mortar and pestle table, because it's gonna have two of them on it. I didn't make any storage stuff. I gotta make a new bed. Nope, not in there. Storage. I also saw these metal storage boxes. I have no idea how they're gonna look, so I'm not gonna make them right now. I really need wood. Wood is like really killing me right now. I think there's some trees right outside this. That is a very big... Never mind. I'm not even gonna ask who dropped that. Yeah, I've been wiping out a lot of the woods around here, trying to collect all this stuff. Or trying to build all this stuff. I think I've clear-cut this entire valley of trees at least 3 times. Ooh, lag. And each time I come back, and they grow back, and I wipe them out again. I could probably do a little bit better if I went and got... I think you can get the mantis and give it an axe and it'll harvest like crazy for you. But I don't have the stuff to go get one right now. So let's go ahead. We're going to make... Where are they? Under wood? No. Miscellaneous? No? Structures. Well, I can eventually make a new bed if I can find some hide somewhere. Furniture! Nope, that's where the vessel is. There you go. Wood. Wooden bench, wooden table. That takes metal. Perfect. Take half of that. And I'll make one bench. Man, my throat has been killing me this week. So I'll take those. We'll take all this back in here. Storage. Take one of those. I will need to collect these back out so I can make a thing. Where are you? Storage. Your S plus. Just show all. Bookshelf. Structure. There we go. I will need one of these. Because I do have some Ingram stuff that I am going to keep. Because eventually we are going to do a mind wipe again. Just because it's convenient. We'll go ahead and put you here. And let's see, where do we want to put this table? I think we'll keep crafting stuff kind of over here a little bit. Not sure what that was. And we'll put you right there. I did not mean to climb up the table. So now I can place these guys. Now we're going to offset them a little. So it's not super uniform, as much as I am about symmetry. So now we've got a little bit of a working base. That means I can tear that thing down. We can actually have room for our dinos to sit over here. We can start going out and taming some more dinos. I will work on replacing these walls and this gate and that wall and that gate with S+. Because these little guys are annoying. These fence foundations are doing the job, but they're not very good at it. That and I like being able to see my walls kind of uniform. So I think I'll have to do, what I'll have to do is I'll say, like, I actually like the placement of this gate, but I don't like having these this foundation right here in the middle. But if I get rid of it, it destroys the gate. So I actually like the placement of this, because it's right here on this shelf. If I can keep that, but get rid of everything else and level it out to this, that is what I want to do. On the other side, I'll have to come up with something else, because there's not exactly a good spot to put this gigantic gate, except like right here. This thing is not very friendly for this stuff. I thought about doing a different thing for it, like doing a bridge over to that by tree, doing a little bridge over to that platform or that peninsula kind of thing. But then I decided, nah, it'd be too easy for something to wander in. But now I'm looking at this wall and seeing all these giant holes and thinking, oh my gosh, anything can just wander in through these holes. But yeah. That's gonna be it for this time, guys. If you liked it, hit the like button below. If not, let me know what you don't like in the comments. We have a base. It is fully functional. We will begin actually using it, hopefully next time. Get our screenshot. And then I think also next time we're gonna work on trying to get this area set up. I wanna get this set up pretty quickly so we can start getting some vegetables going, getting some narco berry farms going. And I mean, he's great. Larry is wonderful for collecting narco berries and cactus sap, but having a farm would be really nice. Oh well, that's it for today. It's amazing how long this thing has taken me to build. And it's probably not going to be the last time we do any building for the structure. I'll have to go around. I'll give it the rim. We'll do little decoration pieces here and there. I want to put vessels around. I want to put chairs, benches, tables, stuff like that. But for now, that's it. I will see you guys next time. Ooh, more gunpowder. I'm realizing I have so many projects. I'm going to use this little book right here, and I'm going to mark down all the projects that we have not finished. And we're going to start looking at some of them. Like, this will go on there.